Hi, I'm Nico Pieri, and I'm going to talk to you about information technology in the United States and economic resilience during the COVID-19 pandemic. As COVID-19 spread across the globe, people have greatly reduced their mobility. We all have been spending less time home and more time going out to work, with the exception of the most essential workers of our economy. We'll be spending less time going out to shopping for goods that we need or to enjoy services that require face-to-face interactions, such as concerts or restaurant meals. These abrupt changes have been caused by both voluntary behavior, as nobody wants to get sick or to infect others, but also by lockdowns and other restrictive policies that have been enacted in order to halt the spread of the virus. Anyhow, whether coming from lockdowns or from voluntary behavior, this very sharp drop in mobility has caused an unprecedented economic crisis, as both consumption and production are hit hard. In particular, job losses have been dire. For instance, in the United States, unemployment rate has skyrocketed during the spring of this year. However, humans are a resilient bunch, and businesses and consumers have found a way to carry on their economic activities, at least in part, while avoiding in-person interactions. Working from home has become the norm for so many of us around the world. And for instance, myself, I'm talking to you from the house of my parents in southern Italy. Contactless delivery and contactless payments have become more and more common, and online sales have surged all across the world. What do all these economic remedies to the pandemic have in common? Well, they are all enabled by information technology, that is, the use of computational systems to gather, store, disseminate, and analyze information. And previous research have shown that information technology, also called IT, has led to so many economic gains. For instance, has led to a higher productivity and higher firm growth. But can IT also shield the economy from the pandemic? And in particular, can IT also mitigate the job losses coming from social distancing? Well, the answer to this question is far from clear-cut, as technology may actually exacerbate job losses. It may make easier for companies to substitute away from labor to machine when there is need to limit in-person interactions. Thus, we decide to dig deeper into this question, and we focus on the spring of this year, so kind of the first phase of the pandemic, and we focus on the United States. Also because in the United States, there is lots of data about information technology, unemployment, and people's mobility. In particular, we rely on the fact that the extent to which people stayed more home, and so the extent to which mobility dropped in different parts of the United States, has been quite different during the spring of this year. A bit because infection rates were quite different in places like New York City versus some southern states. In part because, different governors and other local authorities decide to adopt different policies. But for all these reasons, we have seen that the drop in mobility were different in different places in the states. And therefore, we ask, first of all, it is true that in places where mobility dropped the most, and so where people kind of stayed home more, do we also see a stronger surge in unemployment? And then, is this relationship between the drop in mobility and the surge in unemployment different, maybe more muted, in locations where firms, where companies have also adopted information technology more intensively? And to get the answer to these questions, I leave the virtual floor to Yannick Timmer. Thank you.
Thanks, Nico. Now let us compare US states with each other, depending on the level of IT adoption of the firms within these states. This graph shows the result. IT adoption can mitigate the economic consequences from social distancing. On the horizontal axis, we show the extent of social distancing in each state, measured by the decline in mobility of the people living in these states. On the vertical axis, we show the change in the unemployment rate of that state. Let's focus on the lower IT states first. There is a strong relationship between the extent of social distancing and the increase in the unemployment rate. More social distancing is associated with a stronger increase in the unemployment rate. This is not the case for high IT states. More social distancing isn't associated necessarily with a higher increase in the unemployment rate. Let us compare two states with each other. Nevada, a low IT state, and Colorado, a high IT state. In Nevada, the unemployment rate went up by around 25 percentage points, while in Colorado, the unemployment rate went up by only 10 percentage points. Quite a significant difference. Of course, Nevada and Colorado are two very different states. There are many different characteristics. Next, we will delve into individual level data covering tens of thousands of individuals living in the United States to confirm that result. We have a lot of information available about these individuals, where they live, in which state, but also in which metropolitan area. And we know the IT adoption of the firms within the metropolitan area. For these individuals, we also know the education level, the gender, the race, and so on. That allows us to compare two people with each other living in the same state, but in two different metropolitan areas. In response to social distancing, you are much less likely to become unemployed if you're living in a metropolitan area where IT adoption is strong. This confirms our previous result that IT adoption can mitigate the economic consequences due to social distancing from the pandemic. How much can IT mitigate the economic consequences? We know in the United States, the unemployment rate went up to around 14% in April and May 2020. How much would that have been with less IT adoption? IT adoption increased quite significantly over the last 5 years. So if the world would have been hit by the pandemic 5 years ago, we calculate the unemployment rate would have gone up to 16 instead of 14%. A 2 percentage point difference. This is quite a significant difference just because of IT. And imagine what would have happened if the pandemic would have hit the world even before that. But does IT adoption shield everyone? We know certain parts of the population have been harder hit by the pandemic than other parts of the population. This graph shows that IT adoption mitigates the economic consequences for males, females, for high educated individuals, for whites, and for non-whites, but not so for low educated individuals. This means that inequality is unlikely to be exacerbated by IT across races and across genders. But it can increase inequality between high and low educated individuals. What does that mean for policy? This means that everyone should receive IT education so that the benefits of IT adoption can be widely shared across the country. In addition to that, we show that IT adoption can mitigate the economic consequences of the pandemic. That also means that the cost of lockdowns or the cost of social distancing is higher in low IT states or like low IT areas in general. When COVID cases are increasing, this should be in the back of policymakers' minds.